I don't think it's fair that we just smack them across the face with a big discount and expect that's going to be enough that they're actually going to want to create a relationship with me. You know, it's like we can't just market at a customer. We need to market to the customer. And Terry, this kind of leads me into my next question for you is, you know, in that consideration phase, we have to tell them why they would want to even create a relationship with us. I mean, Terry, what would you say to that? I mean, how does a dealership define that?
Well, you define that by talking about the experience that the customer wants. I mean, whether you got a $12,000 discount on your new F-150s or whether you're having your one day only sale, that's not the customer's viewpoint. Everything from an individual level and from the dealership level, we need to think about we're in this to serve them, to serve the car buyers. And the thing they're looking for is not necessarily the biggest discount. I mean, no one wants to get robbed. But they're looking for that great experience. Like I said, just read, 86% say they would pay extra for a better experience. And the experience they're looking for is fast. They want it done much faster. So if you want to get them in there and slow them down and grind them for a few extra bucks, that's going to end up hurting the experience. So they want it fast. They want it fun. They want it fair. And they want it friendly, which means another human being. They would prefer to deal with the same customer, with the same salesperson through the process. And if that was somebody they already had a relationship with, people who have a prior relationship with their salesperson before they get to the dealership, they close faster, they're more likely to close, they leave bigger grosses, and they give you higher CSI scores. It's a win-win for everybody if you just make more friends.